Greetings, Eric Backer. Thanks for coming back and watching my videos. A question I got asked, a very interesting question, was, is there a connection between ammonia and candida? So ammonia is a compound that's normally found in the body, mainly through the breakdown of amino acids. It's not bad to have ammonia because, in fact, this gets shunted really into the liver through the portal vein. And then the hepatocytes or the liver cells actively break ammonia down to stuff called urea, which basically gets used in the Krebs cycle, so for energy production. So it's important to keep your liver in really good shape when you've got an issue with fungal disease. So people who drink alcohol, for example, are not going to be in a good place. So let me read out a little bit of stuff that I've printed off from a study, and I'll put the study down, the link below, in the description box. So this study was conducted in 2011. So candida is a really big problem, and candida albicans is the main fungal pathogen that causes so many problems for people. It can actively change its cellular form into a hyphal form, and it does so by altering the pH around it. And in fact, it can do so in less than 12 hours. It can change the pH from 4 to 7 because it likes an alkaline environment for that elongation. And this is what causes dissemination or movement of this sort of like strand form into different parts of the body. But please don't put comments down, I've got candida of the brain, or travels through my blood and things like that, like a lot of people, you know, believe it does. But candida can morph or change, and it can alter its body shape, and it can even alter the pH of the tissues that it's around. So pH homeostasis is critical for all organisms. In the fungal organism, fungal pathogen candida albicans, pH adaptation is critical for virulence in distinct host niches. We demonstrate that beyond adaptation, candida albicans actively neutralizes the environment from acidic to alkaline pH. Under acidic conditions, this species can raise pH from 4 to 7 in less than 12 hours, resulting in auto-induction of the yeast hyphal transition, a critical virulence trait. Extracellular alkalization has been reported to occur in several fungal species, but under specific conditions that we describe, the phenomena is considerably more rapid than previously observed. So what they're saying here, there's definitely a connection between this change and ammonia production. So ammonia production occurs. So you've got to be careful with candida because ammonia can also be linked up with, for example, brain fog and things like that. So it can get into the bloodstream. But the body's pretty good at getting rid of ammonia, clearing it from the body. But I have seen people with all kinds of pH problems and inability to get their pH maintained or stabilized, at a nice kind of a level. And often when you've got a big problem with yeast or fungus in the body, you're going to have a lot of pH issues of the gut. And these pH issues of the gut can then, of course, favor dysbiotic flora or bad bacteria to really flourish and to take off. So the gut likes a stable pH. But as you can see, candida albicans can change that pH environment and create a huge amount of disarray. It's a bit like you've got a room full of really nice people, cool people at a party, but then always that one guy gets in there and creates a problem and acts like a real turkey, and then throws the whole balance out, and then some people are going to leave and things like that. So, well, I wouldn't know because I never used to go to parties. I'm not really a party kind of person. I'm a party pooper, I suppose, but I'm not the candida guy that walks in the room and messes everything up. So the point I'm trying to make here is if you've got a candida problem or you've identified you've got the problem, you can now start to understand how candida can alter the environment in the body and induce a higher ammonia state and create all kinds of problems as a result of that. Now, if you've got liver issues, you may not clear sufficient ammonia from the body, and that can cause a tremendous amount of problems for people. So there you have it. There's definitely a connection between ammonia and candida. Thanks for tuning in.